Assalamu alaikum. My name is Sidra Akhil and my roll number is 211. I am from group number 26 and the topic which was assigned to my group is acute and chronic rhinitis, and my subtopic is intranasal corticosteroid therapy in rhinitis. Now, I am going to give a brief info about rhinitis. Rhinitis is defined as the inflammation of lining of nose. It is also known as coryza. It is irritation of mucous membrane. This inflammation is caused by bacteria, virus, or allergens. It is characterized by nasal symptoms including rhinorrhea, sneezing, and nasal blockage. Chronic rhinitis is defined as presence of two or more symptoms, one of which is nasal blockage or nasal discharge, and the other is facial pain. Facial pain is pain in any part of the face, which is for more than 12 weeks with inflammatory signs. Chronic rhinitis is confirmed by nasal endoscopy or CT scan. Now, we are moving towards intranasal corticosteroids. It is a most effective therapy for rhinitis. It is used to treat allergic nasal obstruction and chronic rhinitis. They are well tolerated by most of the patient because it is associated with less side effects. Usually, we give intranasal corticosteroids for chronic rhinitis. Now, mechanism of corticosteroids. Corticosteroids interact with specific steroid receptors in the cytoplasm, and this steroid nucleus then move into the cell for protein synthesis. Among the proteins synthesized, the one is lipocortin. Lipocortin is second messenger of glucocorticoids, which inhibit the breakdown of arachidonic acids, which in turn inhibit the formation of leukotrienes and prostaglandins. When leukotrienes and prostaglandin inhibits, then the symptoms of rhinitis reduce. Now, what is the role of this therapy? They reduce itching, sneezing, rhinorrhea. Rhinorrhea is free discharge of nasal fluid and congestion. They are also beneficial in relieving cough. They also improve all nasal symptoms and ocular symptoms. These agents also have demonstrated efficacy for non-allergic rhinitis and rhinitis medicamentosa. Rhinitis medicamentosa is caused by prolonged use of topical decongestion. Now, case study. AC is an 8-year-old boy with allergic rhinitis and asthma. For asthma, he is taking budesonide flexhalers, and for the rhinitis, he is taking loratadine. His mother also reports sneezes, complain of itchy nose and eyes, and he does not sleep well at night. His asthma has been well controlled in the past, but now he is experiencing some shortness of breath. Now, we are moving towards SOAP notes. In SOAP notes, first subject. The gender is male and the age is 8 years. Patient complaint is sneezing, itchy nose and eyes, and shortness of breath with sleeping problem. Medical history is of asthma, which is now well controlled. Current medication is loratadine and budesonide. Now, object. During his examination, we observe that he breathes exclusively through his mouth, sniffs frequently, rubs his nose, and we also notice dark circles under his eyes. Now, assessment. AC is displaying classical sign of allergic airway disease in children. He is sniff and snort because of nasal discharge. The upward rubbing of the nose with the palm of the hand is known as allergic solute, which is shown in this diagram, the upward movement of nose with hand. It is because of nasal itching. The other is infraorbital discoloration can develop with frequent rubbing of the eyes in patients. With severe ocular itching, the resultant dark circles under the eyes are commonly known as allergic shiners. In this diagram, we see the allergic shiners. It is also known as night eye, which is because of ocular symptoms. If we cannot treat symptoms, then it leads to facial abnormalities and formation of transverse nasal crease. The transverse nasal crease is groove which is usually white lying between upper two-third and the lower third of the nose, which is shown in this diagram, the upper third and the lower third of the nose. Now the plan is, we give him budesonide 32 microgram spray to actuation in each nostril twice daily for rhinitis. We instruct him to clean his nose before using nasal inhaler, as if there is a nasal blockage, then the drug may not deposit to the intended site of action. And if the drug is not deposited to the intended site of action, then there is less action or no action. If he is severely congested, then we give him a short course of decongestant before intranasal corticosteroids. And if he experiences severe exacerbation, due to which he is unable to sleep or attend school, then we give him oral corticosteroid, that is betamethasone, which is 0.005 to 0.05 milligram per kg 8 hourly. And if we also give him short course of systemic corticosteroids, that is prednisone 125 to 300 microgram per kg 8 hourly for acute asthma. Now, budesonide. Overview: this medication is synthetic corticosteroid, which is used for inhalation purpose. It is used as an inhaler, and it is used to treat severe allergies. The strength of this medicine is 32 microgram spray. The dose for adult is 1 spray once daily and maximum of 4 spray. And for pediatrics, that is children under 6 to 12 years, we give 1 spray once daily and maximum of 2 spray. We give this medication for the treatment of asthma, rhinitis, ulcerative colitis, Crohn's disease, and dermatosis. The contraindication is diabetes mellitus, glaucoma, hypertension, osteoporosis, and pulmonary TB. Side effects which are associated with this medicine is peptic ulceration, osteoporosis, suppression of adrenal function, ocular hypertension, and Cushing-like features. This medicine causes osteoporosis. That is why we don't give him to patients of the osteoporosis. Now the notes. Although nasal corticosteroids have excellent profile, but there is also some local adverse effect, and the most stated adverse effect is epistasis. Epistasis is facial trauma, and it is also known as nose bleeding with excessive nasal dryness. If we guide patient that how to take this nasal spray, then the side effect may be reduced. Therapeutic benefit of nasal steroids is usually appear within few days, but also some newer medicine, that is budesonides, also relieve symptoms within hours. But it is reasonable if we advise patient that they get their maximum benefit up to 3 weeks. There is also systemic administration of these drugs can cause numerous but serious side effects. In such cases, a short course of relative high dose corticosteroid, so-called burst therapy, can be administered for about 5 to 10 days. Thank you.